Another common misconception in downward facing dog is that our heels have to touch the mat, or that we should work towards our heels coming all the way down to the mat. And often that will lead to students walking their hands and feet closer together until they can make that happen. And then that becomes even more challenging to get your hips high and to send weight back into your heels. And so you may feel more weight in your hands with that shorter stance. So last week we talked about a good way to figure out the placement between your hands and feet is to start in plank pose. So if you start in plank pose and you lift your hips up and back, and even though your legs are straight, your heels aren't touching the ground, it's totally fine. Some of that may be tightness through the backs of your legs and your feet. Some of it may just be how your bones are put together. You may never be able to put your heels down to the ground. So if you've been worried about that, don't worry about that. It certainly doesn't make you a bad yogi. You are still a wonderful person if your heels don't touch the ground in downward facing dog. All right. So again, if it's the makeup of your bones, if it's just the way your body's put together, your heels will never go down to the ground. But if it's tightness, there are a few exercises or stretches that we can do to address that. So I do want to take some time this week to show you some ways to stretch out the backs of the lower part of your leg and your feet. And so the first one, I like to start on my hands and knees, and then you curl your toes under. And for some of us, this can already be enough, and you may want to stay right here. But we can begin to add some intensity by shifting our hips back, and then maybe walking our hands in, maybe even sit back onto your heels, lifting all the way up. Now, you may feel this in your toes. You may feel this along the bottoms of your feet. You may not feel this at all. This may be no big deal. But just to confirm that whatever you're feeling is correct for you, and certainly you should listen to what your body is telling you and adjust accordingly, less intense, take your hands forward or even bring them to blocks or all the way forward into a tabletop position. But once you've found kind of the position that is maybe tolerable is a good, at least for me, way to describe it. This is pretty intense for me. Spend a few breaths here. Spend a few moments here. And then when you've had enough, lean forward and you can tap your feet out. All right, give that a try and then check back tomorrow and I'll have some more ways that you can begin to stretch out the backs of your legs and your feet.